2 weeks.
On the one hand, it's being absorbed in the upper one, and on the other hand, we're building the Creator. So these two sentences seem contradictory. That's how it seems. But in truth, it's not so. Because the upper force has many names. Besides the ten ineffable names, and everything we can feel is Him, and all the phenomena that we can even detect in our reality are Him. There's nothing else. There's none else besides Him, means that in our perception, in the will to receive that He created, there is nothing but how we feel Him, according to equivalence of form or inequivalence of form. We perceive it in various ways that we judge with respect to ourselves as good, bad, pleasant, unpleasant. But really, there is nothing more than Him. So all of these forms appear with respect to us in our desire. And according to our level of equivalence of form, this level of equivalence of form comes to the creature in the forms of still vegetative inanimate, on which the Creator needn't do any work of adapting Himself or to the Creator. He just perceives the Creator as still or vegetative or animate when it assumes this form. It's called, "And the name of the Lord will be upon you," without choice, effort, knowledge, any understanding or awareness. And there is the form of the Creator which the creature can perceive according to the equivalence, to the congruence, to the effort, and the work on the part of the created being where it by itself adjusts itself to the Creator. This form is called Adam, man. And because the creature is the one who draws, extends this form by understanding, by awareness, by the effort, so it's called man's work. And it's considered that a person creates the Creator. In each one, this form appears individually, personally, although there are rules about it. So we can talk about revealing the forms of the Creator to the creature. But still, each one accepts it, receives it personally, and each one builds the Creator, makes the Creator according to his effort and according to his success in this. And therefore, we, in the manifestation of the Creator toward the creature, we distinguish the degrees of still vegetative inanimate, which are necessary for the existence of the created being, so that the creatures have certain forms from which they can approach the making of the Creator, the manifestation of the Creator in them, in forms that are dependent on the creature, on raising man, on revealing the chisaron, the lack or deficiency. And by the still vegetative inanimate, these forms of the creator already appearing in the creature, through it, he can continue the revelation of the creator himself. And understand how he creates the creator within him.